Okay, so here's an example calculation for the photoelectric effect. And so we are looking for the maximum kinetic energy for electrons that are ejected from an aluminum metal surface. We're going to use 150 nanometer light, and we're also told that the work function for aluminum is 6.54 times 10 to the negative 19 joules. Okay, so as we begin, let's go ahead and remind ourselves of a few equations, okay? So one of the equations that we're going to be looking at is the equation that relates the kinetic energy of the ejected electron is equal to the energy of the photon minus the work function for the metal, okay? And so as long as this energy of the photon is high enough to overcome this work function, then an electron will be ejected with some kinetic energy, okay? And so this is what we're looking for here. And we use the term maximum kinetic energy because that's just the most that is possible, okay? So basically we're looking for the kinetic energy of the ejected electrons. Okay, so let's start with the energy of the photon, okay? So we are given a wavelength, but we're not given the actual energy of the photon itself. So let's also remind ourselves that the energy of a photon is equal to hc over lambda. Okay, where lambda is the wavelength, and H is Planck's constant, 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34 joule seconds, okay? And actually, let's go ahead and fix that H because it looks bad, okay? And C is the speed of light, 2.998 times 10 to the eighth meters per second, okay? So remind ourselves of that. So let's go ahead and calculate the energy of this photon. Now we have 150 nanometers nanometer light, and so we do need to do a small conversion. But in this case, I'm going to go ahead and do it as we're calculating the energy of this photon. Okay, so let's go ahead and plug in. So 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34 joule seconds. Okay. Boy, oh boy, that's pretty hard to read too. Okay, so that's negative 34 joule seconds, okay, Planck's constant, times the speed of light, 2.998 times 10 to the eighth meters per second, okay? And then here's where I'm gonna do the conversion from nanometers to meters, just right in the problem. And what I'm gonna do is remind myself that there are 10 to the 9 nanometers in 1 meter. So I'm going to write 150 times 10 to the negative 9 meters. Okay? Now we've been doing the conversions where we convert from nanometers to meters. So if we were to do that, then we take 150 nanometers and 1 times 10 to the 9th nanometers in 1 meter, so you can see that we divide them and we would end up with 1.5 times 10 to the negative 7 meters. Okay, so all I've done is just taken a little bit of a shortcut, so this is non-standard scientific notation, but it works. So let's go ahead and calculate the energy of this photon. So as we put that in the calculator, then we are going to get, let's just go ahead and do that, 6.626 negative 34 times 2.998 to the eighth power. That gives me 1.986 times 10 to the negative 25. I'm going to divide that by 150 times 10 to the negative 9. And I end up with 1.32 times 10 to the negative 18 joules. Okay. All right. So now we have the energy of our photon. Okay. So I'm going to go to the next slide. And then I'm going to write down a few of our key tidbits of information, okay? So next slide. All right, and so we were told that our work function for aluminum was 6.54 times 10, ooh, that's messy. 6.54 times 10 to the negative 19 joules, Okay? And remember the symbol for that is phi. Okay? And we also have the energy of our photon now. Okay? And that is 1.32 times 10 to the negative 18 joules. Okay? And we're also going to write down our equation, and that is E photon minus the work function. Okay? All right, and I think we're ready to plug everything in. So let's go ahead and do that. So the kinetic energy. So the kinetic energy is equal to 1.32 times 10 to the negative 19 joules. So this becomes pretty easy at this point, minus 6.54 times 10 to the negative 19 joules. Okay? And after we do that math, then we end up with the kinetic energy of the ejected electron is equal to 7.36 times 10 to the negative 20 joules. Okay, so now if we wanted to extend this concept, we could actually figure out how fast those electrons were ejected from the surface. So how fast were they traveling after they were ejected? So if you want to think about how to do that, then go ahead, but later on we'll do another example demonstrating that concept.